fellow programmers. So let's hope you dug some info on internal static and expression bodied members. Hope you know what they all are. If you don't, I hope I gave a good enough explanation. Static just means you don't need an instance. What's an instance? This is an instance. A variable, that's an instance. Static just means you only need to create once. You don't need to create thousands and thousands and thousands of times. That's just extensive. But you don't need to create it many times, it's only created once. That's it. And hope you understood internal and expression bodied methods. Like I said, just throw this instead of putting, they don't just shift around the methods. They believe just call this directly. But since I'm using C# VNext support, I don't think I can use the full thing. It won't be that great. But I believe that's what it does, like the internal in C++. Inline. Inline isn't something you would want to try. Nothing. Inline isn't anything that pops in private world. INLINE. See, nothing. That's because inline isn't a thing in C#. So let's get back. _ directional. This just resets the directions. And then we do transform dot set start valid position. We think that's supposed to be, actually we'll do that when we get to extension method. It's supposed to be set valid start position. It's an extension method. We'll take a look at the transform. As you all know, has no set valid set start valid position. It doesn't, trust me, that's not a thing, that's I created myself. We'll take a look at that when we get to, that'll be just after I complete player. Last collect time is equal to time dot time minus time dot between collects times 2. I didn't have to put parentheses. I can put parentheses. Oh sorry, that's something I have to enable myself. Here's how you do it. Options somewhere advanced. Maybe, I don't know. There is, I can't seem to be able to find it right now. Why did it get disabled? Okay, I think, that's only in C++. I'll show you that when I get to C++. I don't think this is possible over here. Anyway. So, in fixed operator, I could have set this into a, I don't think Unity supports this, this expression body members. If player press manager dot touch mode, and transform dot move based on direction. What is this? Again, touch mode is static. You only need to play a press manager dot touch mode. No, I is, this is not an instance. Class for easy hard disk data access. Player press. Simple. Touch mode is another method. It's a boolean. I might have seen the boolean player press. And touch mode key and all that. So speaking of which, let's control K, control C. That and let me issue something. It's gonna go wrong with it, so no, nothing went wrong, did something go wrong? No, it's not even used, where do I keep this? But it can be very helpful right now. See, that I had to create them manually. Here's something, select this, actually disable these two, and okay, done. Hash code is generated. Hash code is equal to Y, but is something that happens. Is something new that is there is mine. And after values holder, what's this? It's a system that's serializable, meaning we can show up here. I think I forgot to show that over there. Serialize field, meaning this is sure. This is an that gets set accessor. Actually, there's something I could do. Okay, so yeah, that's a brand new use, just like that. After value, this is a constructor, by the way. You know what, I'm just gonna keep this the exact same thing. I think I'm trailing away a little bit. And there it is. So this is all there is to see over here. That this is just constructs it with the two parameters you give. Dead camera, current avatar values, and touch mode. Boolean player press also pretty useful. And if it is touch mode, you might have seen that over there. Then we move based on direction. Direction is diagonal or speed. Move based on direction. This is another two extensions. This is an overloaded extension methods. I will show that everything right after I complete this. So in update, if it is not touch mode, then we do up, down, left, right. Yeah. So direction std is equal to. So this is just for checking whether or not we have pressed the left arrow, right arrow, up, down arrow, up arrow, or down arrow. Why did I make extension method? It's not just that because I wanted to show you. Of course, I did want to show you what extension method is. But there's also another reason. Because I had to use it in enemy as well. So copy pasting, not very good. And we have this on collision enter. So if the collision, if the game object dot layer is equal to grid generator dot I dot game object dot layer plus 1, what does that mean? Okay, so hexagonal grid, when we do add layer, when we say end of terrain, it is just above hexagonal grid, right below. So it is hexagonal grid and then it is directly end of terrain. That's what we are doing. So that's what it means. We are just adding one to the layer. This checks if this is the exact same layer. Then we just move backwards. Like this. Like that. See? This just throws it back. You might have seen that whenever you touch it. Yeah, and keep that in mind. And if it is directly equal to the game object grid generator dot I dot game object dot layer, then so if collision dot game object is equal to, and then we create a new tile, a tile game object, it just refers to collision dot game object and mesh renderer. By the way, I'd like to point out whatever make changes you make in tile will also affect this collision dot game object. Why? Because this tile, whenever you assign something to it, it keeps this as a special F12. Yeah, this equal to operator should have been like that, but I don't know why it's like that, but this is how it, believe it works. It counts the number of references you have, and then it changes everything in all those references. I don't know how Unity works this, DLLs are, I'm not trying to change, I don't like doing that. And tile mesh, this means tile.getComponent, mesh render, just gives the mesh render a component from this tile. And if the tile mesh is material, that if its texture is main text and my material is equal to main text, if they're the same, I mean if they're not the same, then we check if actually don't look at that. Look at this. If it is time dot time is greater than last collect time and time between collects. This just means as if enough time has passed. And then we just for each through all of them, and if talmish dot material, and if it is the enemy, and if it is the same as the enemy's material that the current enemy's material, then we do that enemy's, then we decrement that enemy's squad. So we compare this current talmish's texture with the enemy's texture. Ah, my tongue keeps slipping. And if they are the same, then we decrement its score. And if talmish material is, then we assign the talmish material to my material and increase our score. Then we set last collect time to time dot time. And if it collide with an enemy, then we game. Then it's game over. And here in the change after we get two random values. This is a 0 and a models dot length. What models? Model group. Well, it should be model groups, but since it has already been assigned in UDM, I'm not gonna touch that. And then we for each through each model in the models group. Each model group in the models actually do control R, control R. And if it is not multiple models, if there are not multiple models, then we just set the first one to false, because that's the only thing that is to set to false. And if there are multiple models, then we set all of them to false. No model should be available when you first set. Then if there are not multiple models, then we just set the default one to true. Else, we set the random value. Random value to random dot range 0 models R value models at length. Okay, so whatever does this mean? This just gets the, let me rename it. Random index for model groups apply, and R value 2 models in model group. So then we set that to random.range. This makes things very descriptive. Models and a random index for model groups. This just gets which current model is referred to by random index for model group. This random index for model groups refers to, and then we set, and then we get that length. It's model game object. That's the length actually. And then we for each models in random next model group with model game object, and we set each of those to false. Then we set the model referred to. Then we get the model group referred to by random index for model groups. Then we get the model referred to, the actual model referred to by the random model in model group, this, and then we set that to true. This is extremely specific. Okay, go through it a few more times. There is the full thing. Let me just scroll to the side. this is the full thing. Pause and ponder about all of this and make sure it digests properly. I'm just gonna scroll through very slowly so all of you can read it very properly. Hope this all makes sense to you. And then we'll do clear-pref-manager.currentAfterValues. And then we set it a new after value, create a new after value. How am I able to get switches and utilities? Because I'm using utility of that. That's how I'm able to get it directly. So then we set the random index for model group. This thing has to be extremely specific. I had to create it up there so it can be reused over here. If we made changes over here, then it would still refer to the same thing. And then in the for each, we set the random index for model group. Just we need to enemies. We set the enemies model. This gives you utilities.afterValuesHolder, whereas this one takes in an index. Well, there's also another overload, I think. No, we'll get there when we get there. This set after just gives you utilities. It can be simplified, so simplify. There we go. AVATARHOLDER apply. And then we do the exact same thing up here, except instead of referring to random index model for model groups, for each of that, we just refer to AFTERHOLDER.AFTERGROUPValue, and for each random index model for model, random index for models in model group, very long. It's a set after and set model extreme. Actually, you know what? On second thought, F12. Is it used anymore? I don't feel too safe about it. You know what? Never mind about it. Anyway, so, this is after group value, we just refer, and for this random index for models in model group, we refer to after subgroup value. Very good. And yeah, that's just does the same thing as up there. So, that's much shorter, except could have called this itself, but then again, this doesn't take any parameters. Then we just set its after to after. Oh look, this is a brand new, this looks much more concise, right? See, earlier it would have looked like quick action and refactoring. Imagine this 6 more times. Not very good at all. So that's why this looks much more concise, doesn't it? And then again, Unity can still use this because, well, it understands this. That's Ceplef, right? So let's just go over what I did over there. In the arrow holder, arrow scaler, just was scaling it up or down. It's a transform. Keep in mind, see, it's not a rect transform because scaling is better in transforms than in struct transforms. By my mentality, I'm not too sure about what you think, but it's better in transforms than in rect transforms. So I overridden this rect transform, the transform, and then set it back to a rect transform. Rect transform is used for UI, whereas a normal transform is used for game objects. But rect transforms are horrible at scaling, trust me. You have to set their anchor point, anchors point, their center, and all of that. And so we do left, down left, upright, down right, and we manually set them over here. Left, down, left, down, up, left. Go through it one more time, all of this. Hope all of this digests. And I'll need one more break. My throat gets a little bit more tired after talking so long. It's already been half an hour. So yeah, that's about it. So there'll be lots of more videos. I still have to go for extension methods in game objects. So hope all of this digests to you, and again, thanks for watching.